When a virus replicates, mutation in its genetic sequence occurs, which may alter some characteristics of the virus. If the altered virus mutated significantly enough from the original virus and gained survival advantages through these mutations, it may spread rapidly in a host population, becoming a new variant. The SARS-CoV-2 gamma variant is a mutated strain from the original SARS-CoV-2. It includes the PEP1 strain. The gamma variant was first found in November 2020 in Brazil. As of July 2021, it has spread to at least 62 countries with a cumulative prevalence worldwide of 2%. While in Brazil, it has a higher cumulative prevalence at 70%. On 11th of January 2021, the gamma variant was classified as a variant of concern. What are the key mutations acquired by the gamma variant that makes it a variant of concern? From the genetic sequencing of many virus samples from infected individuals, it was discovered that the gamma variant has accumulated over 22 mutations with about 12 mutations on the spike protein. This information is of great significance as the spike protein is involved in both the transmissibility of the virus and the immune response by the host against the virus. This is the general structure of the SARS-CoV-2, and the red protrusions on the surface of the virus are the spike proteins. For the SARS-CoV-2 to replicate in host cells, it must first use its receptor binding domain on the spike protein for attachment to the cells. In addition, the cell surface protease TMPRSS2 facilitates the cutting of a part on the spike protein, called the furin cleavage site, allowing the virus to enter host cells for viral replication. Moreover, most antibodies generated through infection or vaccination are stimulated by the spike protein. In other words, the immune system of the host eliminates the SARS-CoV-2 by recognizing the spike protein. From the list of mutations on the spike protein, a few mutations have been extensively studied to understand their impact. The most notable examples are the N501Y and D614G mutations, which are common in other variants of concern, including alpha and beta variants. N501Y mutation is the main cause of the increase in transmission rate of the virus, which led to spikes in COVID-19 cases. To know more about the impacts of N501Y and D614G, feel free to watch the video for alpha variant on my channel. Gamma variant also has the E484K, which is common in other variants of concern, including the beta variant. This mutation is the main cause of the reduction in efficacies of vaccines, as most available vaccines are constructed based on the spike protein of the original SARS-CoV-2. To know more about the impact of E484K, feel free to watch the video for beta variant on my channel. Other mutations in the gamma variant include the L18F, T20N, P26S, D138Y and R190S mutations with amino acid substitutions as listed. These mutations contribute to the viral resistance towards different antibodies due to the changes in their structure. The accumulation of these mutations at the spike protein increases the ability of gamma variant to avoid being targeted by antibodies, leading to a high degree of immune evasion, especially when many antibodies specifically target the K417 or E484 amino acids on spike protein. In general, the mutated characteristics of the gamma variant include more easily spread among the community than the original SARS-CoV-2, and increased resistance towards the combination of bamlanivimab and etesevimab monoclonal antibody treatment, while other emergency use authorization antibody treatments are still available. Examples of vaccines that conducted studies against the gamma variant include Pfizer, AstraZeneca, Moderna, and Sinovac. Current available vaccines are still effective in preventing the serious complications of COVID-19, including hospitalizations and deaths, with slight reduction in efficacies. Vaccines not listed by no means signifies non-efficacy, but rather due to limited available data. Vaccines listed also by no means signifies lesser efficacy than non-listed vaccines, but rather due to the available data from studies conducted. Therefore, this provides evidence that although current vaccines have reduced efficacies, two doses of these vaccines are still effective against the gamma variant with more than 50% efficacy, which is the efficacy cutoff point set by the Food and Drug Administration. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share or subscribe to my channel. If you would like to learn more about other variants of concern, check out this series.